What you gotta say to the people, man? It's a new video. What you gotta say to the people?
Oh, man, it's a new video.
Yeah.
We already know what my motto is. Stay in school, eat ass.
Eat ass, baby. All right, guys, what's up? And what's Gucci? I told y'all we had a part two coming up, man. It's me and the young ass eater. Lil Kinky Twist. We about to hit this family thrift and then a few more. I was gonna do this whole like little back to school montage, but honestly, I just felt like finding clothes and stunting on these hoes. So let's go. Oh yes, daddy. This is definitely appropriate for school. It's spreading a positive message. Dare to resist drugs and violence, children. This was made in the USA at Anvil Polo. Ooh. That's that vintage gym coach looking swag. So if you guys want to go to school incognito, this would be the piece for sure. What you got?
The foreign exchange student swag.
Where do you live?
America.
Oh, that Croatia? Bro, what you found over here, man?
Bro. Fuck. On the fucking grail.
What type of material is that, bro?
That's fucking... That's that beautiful. Soft. Lovely. Velvet.
Alright, man, this is what I'm talking about, baby. We finding some little essentials to keep it popping like a pimple. This is that 90s colorway, that vintage swagoo. If you guys got that polo dress code, that would work for sure. This is like some abstract Boogle Boy, also known as Kugel Koi by the Crips. Little incognito camo, not too bad. Also, man, essential Tommy for your mommy striped little tee right there. And then you have the Chaps Ralph Lauren, looking like some pool water tiles. Mosaic design going on right there. So a lot of little options for more like hipster type of vibes. We out here. Oh, holy crack, that's a home run, daddy.
Deep to right field, way back, he has done it again.
Oh, here you go, all you supreme fucking hype beasts. Know nothing about the people you rock on your shirt. You got the Morrissey tee, but you know. Hey man, if you guys are named Aaron, you know what I'm saying, you are in luck, because we got a variety of polos for you.
Where is Aaron right now?
Bruh, fucking heat. All right, man, we out here. Oh, those Balenciagas, the one that look like socks. What?
Hey, these is bloody shoes.
You got the World Wrestling Federation Undertaker's Tattoo Shop, Death Valley. I got mine in hell. Bruh, that is straight up fire.
Little gym slash drug bag.
Okay. Come and get your money, little duffel bag, boy.
If it hella like shin guards and like balls and shit in there, or you can just fit hella bricks. Bricks.
Bricks.
Bricks like a motherfucking project. Got bricks like a motherfucking project. Got bricks like a motherfucking project. Got bricks like a.
Man, look at these motherfuckers. Hot as hell. Hot as hell.
Hot as hell.
What you found, Big Daddy Kinky?
I found these.
What them's is?
14s, I guess. Right there.
That's the only reason I knew. The boy knows how to read his Roman numerals. But yeah, man, Lil Kinky found the Air Jordan 14s. The cherries, not too shabby for daddy. Hey, man, shout out to you, brother. I'm proud of you, dog.
Wait a second, Lil Kinky just spotted it. Oh, through the grapevine, another pair of really disgusting Thunder 14s. Bro, that shit is moldy as hell. It survived the flood at least. These are size 6.5 wide. I think that's a solid pass. This thing got like 3 spider pregnancies on the back. Lord have mercy, brothers.
Ew, that's gross.
What you got?
I found some more Jordans, bro.
Ooh-hoo-hoo. Hey, bro, Michael Jordan in a different stance, but still got the elephant print.
Yeah, it's super rare.
Super rare. Very rare. All right, we got a couple more little scoops, bruh. They got the shorts to match the Dare to Resist Drugs gym coach fit. You guys already know, perfect for the summertime. Ain't got no pockets, but that means they're fanny pack worthy for sure. Also down below, Lord have mercy, you got the Father's Day, the Great Escape. So it appears this father is trying to avoid all responsibilities or just, you know, taking a luxury day to himself. And then you got the Kyle Busch with the CarQuest racing tee right here, baby. NASCAR, fast car race, something heller. And then last and not least, you know, to complete the little finds for the day in this thrift, you have the Chaps Ralph Lauren vintage jacket. It's like tritone, navy red and tan. Man, that shit looking like a delicious bagel in the colorway. I love it. All right, guys, man, we dig and we delved and we got some heat in this bitch. Yo, check it out, man. We got 2 Native American themed pieces.
the University of Illinois Illini jacket, heavily embroidered. And then you guys know, man, I can't be racist because I love me a Black Hawk. You know what I'm saying?
Shut the fuck up, bitch!
You got the Chicago Blackhawks reversible pro player jacket. The sleeves are red, the base is black. It is 2-in-1, and then on the back it says Blackhawks. That is absolutely brazy. Lightning striking on that P was good.
Oh, more Jordans?
Bruh, what are those? All right, man, so yeah, we're just sitting in a fat honey sack of heat. What we got, Kinky, bro? Break it down for him, man.
Oh, God.
We found,
right,
man.
So right here, we got that little Asian exclusive right there. I don't know what language that is, so I'm not even gonna guess.
Uh-huh.
Kodak, picture friendly.
Uh-oh.
And then on the back, that's a Kodak moment if I ever seen one.
Bro, that's that polychrome graphic, dude. That polychrome. This ain't that bullshit you find in Forever 21, neither. This is that original, straight out of China or Japan, wherever Kodak is, you know, originated from. I honestly don't know.
It's the Kodak, the finesse kid. Boy, who hot is me?
All right, now we got that little NASCAR jacket right here. Now, if you're a fan of the show, you'll know that Paul already has himself one of these. So
yes, I do indeed.
You already know, twin fits coming soon.
Hey, you ain't winning if you ain't twinning, people. Big facts. Look at the back.
Look at the beautiful graphic on the back.
Holy hell. You got the car. You got this nice bread little racing stripe. Then you got the T-Mac. Houston Pocket Rockets. You guys know H-Town most assuredly holds it down.
It's H-Town, Texas. Braeswood, baby.
And then more racewear. You got the Dale Jr., baby. Baseball jerseys. This is very clean. You got the Big B. Hey, Big B's up. You feel me?
Hey, Big B's.
Hey, Big B's up, baby. And then when you flip around, bro, you got the Pedophile University, Penn State. Just kidding, I know a lot of you guys aren't pedophiles. That's a really bad joke, I'm sorry. You got a couple Crip colorway pieces. You got the New York Mets vintage jacket right here. It's a nice little satin jacket. Candy, chameleon, glistening in the light, size small, very, very old. You got the Levi's extremely old acid wash jacket. Why did my camera just look like it fell in the toilet full of dehydrated piss? I don't know. Then you got, shout out that boy Perry. You know what I'm saying? The platypus. You got the all embroidered dragon with this very, very dope Mongolian horsehair. Interior black, exterior Korean. Dude, this is some straight up swell sexiness if I ever seen it. God damn. What's up?
One of your pant legs is drooping.
My pant leg is drooping?
Yeah.
Bro, why you looking at my pants for, dog? Damn, this one is way more sprung than the other one. All right, y'all, we're outside the next store right now, which is a family thrift out here in Bel Air. Shout out to Fresh Prince. This is where he's from. So this is the down south version. This is right by Plaza de America for all you guys who live in Houston and are trying to come to the same store as I come to and not find shit, because usually this store is lacking. But hopefully today, that is not the case. Let's see, shall we? What'd you know, wrestled out the marshland now?
I found me a couple skeeters.
Couple skeeters? Good Lord, look at them penetrate, man. That's how you know that's a skeeter doing his job, brother. Hey, you ain't winning if you ain't what?
You ain't twinning.
Hell yeah. Bruh, man, I was perusing through the jacket section, and all I have to say is, man, I was happy to see they had the jackets back out, but I was not happy to see that for this basic North Face, they're charging $30, dude.
Trippy.
Like, absolutely out of their damn minds, man. What those is?
Some thick-ass wheels.
Hell yeah. Those some thick balls, boy. Hey man, also they got a little Furby. You heard me?
You heard me?
Dude, Fuzz Gang. What's up, man? Belly button lint. Hey dude, they also got this little Chelsea Adidas jersey. Unfortunately, this thing is fraudulent, but it's $3, so I'm still gonna get it because I'm fake as fuck. You heard me?
You heard me?
Yeah. Alright, yo, so that store didn't have anything. We just hopped into Play-Dohs. And I got a nice that's how you get it in style. And oh yeah, these are 40. And they got two pairs of Jordans. They got the little, I'm gonna call these the little Raptor 5s. Those are $40, little size 7Y. Just size alum. These are pretty clean, aside from that little slight discrepancy in the laces. Very dope. Jumpman looking right, no booty crack whatsoever. Size 11, $40. I might as well. Let's do it. Yo, grab that one too. Yo, man. So also in the hat section, low-key Playlist is coming through. They got like crazy vintage snapbacks. These are all really hard. No brands. They can be whatever you interpret them to be.
Exactly.
It's what you interpret it to be.
All right, man. So I got a fat stack of like six of the same print hat. Then they have this different print right here. This is straight up Fresh Prince of Bel Air. So you already know I have to acquire that guy. What you got in hand? Little child Houston pocket rockets little hat. Could I look at those all black shoes too? Yeah, we're just like scoping off the back wall. Oh yeah, that's my size. These are the little black hats right here. These are not in bad condition at all. $45. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and grab these. These look like an all black couch. So Play-Doh's actually does low-key got some stuff. They got the Reebok Classics. They got these Patrick Ewing's. This is the Bun B collab. You gotta eat this. I think these are like called the sushi. I don't know, they're like this color for the fish and the green is that wasabi. These shoes are just way too much, honestly, in terms of like their design. Like that's just a lot to handle. They also got the Flyknit. These are $35, size 11. These are like the Flyknit Chukkas. Bro, this is why I come here, dude. Oh no, they're charging $20 on this windbreaker. Hey man, I caught them slipping on this women's windbreaker. Very dope two-tone floral fuego with the paisley incrustation. 10. I'ma take it. Bruh, this t-shirt is hard too. They got the El Chapo the Last Narco tee. Just know that's $10. I'm copping that. Bro, I've never gone through a Play-Doh's closet as thoroughly as I am right now. Kinky, what you got in hand, buddy?
Some Nikes.
You heard me?
You heard me?
Hey bro, you see that? One for the pain, one for the stink. You got the Stussy, damn. All right, copping that too. Yo, I'm not gonna lie, man. Play-Doh's is coming through with that heat. And they got Eminem on. They have the Bob Marley like band tee right here. That's $6. The Stussy NY LA Tokyo London and Paris floral tee. That's $6. And they have the polo jeans by Ralph Lauren. That is $6 as well. Also, Kinky found this like towel texture Adidas essential tee. It got like a little stripe pocket right there. The Adidas emblem on the bottom. And that is $10. Yup, another little tie-dye. Thing looking like a swim pool getting in the deep end. They got the odd future tee. That's $8. I'll take it. Bro, what is going on in here, man? This is size medium. The guest little essential logo tee. That's $8. I mean, they have a lot of they got a lot of t-shirts. This is like on some high fashion shit for real right here. Yo, low-key banger, bro. They got the polo bear. This is a size small. Damn, that thing is so clean. They're charging $15. I may grab it just to hand it off to one of you guys. What it is? Oh, bro, they got the Robbins jeans. Oh, love. That Robbins on the booty, how much that is?
$40, bro.
$40 for some Robbins, bro, steal. All right, man, so I'm cashing out in Play-Doh's right now. So final review, got the Jordan 5s right there. You got the 13s all blacked out. And then you got the Columbia little sixes looking like pure cocaine. And I got like a million hats and a ton of t-shirts. So I never thought Play-Doh's would come through with this much stuff, but I'm pleasantly surprised today. All right, guys, what up? We just jumped out of Play-Doh's closet. Kinky did come away with the shoe purchase. Go ahead and show them what you got, baby. Holy hell. All right, turn it sideways. Let them get all the angles. But yeah, man, he got the Shamu Air Jordan 1s. How much were them hoes?
They was 50.
50, Tyson. Yup, and then I got three pairs of Jordans. You guys have seen them a million times, but I was gonna hold up another pair of shoe just to do so. But yeah, dude, I mean, we looked around in Play-Doh's closet for a pretty long time. Normally, I don't spend that much time in there at all. And it actually, like, they came through with a bunch of shit. So, pretty satisfying overall. What would you say?
I'd say it was a successful day.
You do?
Just some schlight work, you heard me?
Schlight work? I heard you. You heard us? You did. Killing these songs, leaving a bloody life I rules to. And I'm in it to win it, so I'm somebody that you should get